So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. Main hu Manish Mishra and in this session guys we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. Alright, so let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. Or yahan pe you can also ask any doubt. Alright, so let's begin with the very first question. Consider the following statements regarding the worker population ratio for the year 2018-19 that has been recently released by NSO, and you have to identify the correct statement regarding this worker population ratio data. Alright, so guys, recently NSO has released the 2018-19 worker population ratio data. So you have to tell the correct statement about that. So let's discuss this news. So as I told you, NSO has released this data as per the annual periodic labor force survey. Jo annual periodic labor force survey tha, uske hisab se NSO has released the worker population ratio of each state for the year 2018-19. Aur har state ki percentage aapko yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Just remember the highest worker population ratio, the lowest worker population ratio and the overall worker population ratio of our country. Alright. So highest ratio kiska hai? It's Dadra and Nagar Haveli, 68.4%. Alright. And lowest ratio, once again it is Bihar, which is at the lowest, that's 36.4%. And overall ratio jo humare pure desh ka hai, that is how much? 47.3%. Alright. So yahan pe worker population ratio ka matlab ye hai ki kitne workers kaam karte hai per 100 population. Per 100 population, how many workers are working is the meaning of worker population ratio, which means in Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, of course, the full name is Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, this percentage is 68.4%, which means 68.4 people are working out of 100 in Daman and Diu, while in Bihar, this is 36.4%, while overall, if we talk about the whole country, it's 47.3%. All right. और इसमें इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा डिटेल में पढ़ने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है, there is no need. All right. So let's come back to the question now. You have to identify the correct statements. Highest ratio among all the states and UTs is of Sikkim. So is that Sikkim? No. It's Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu. All right. So this statement is incorrect. Lowest ratio among all the states and UTs is of Uttar Pradesh. No, that is not Uttar Pradesh. That's Bihar. Which means this statement is also incorrect. And India's ratio is 47.3%. Jo India ka ratio hai, wo kitna hai? 47.3%. Yes, this is absolutely correct. 47.3% India ka jo worker population ratio hai, that is how much? 47.3%. Which means we have only one statement which is correct here. And I think the options are wrong here. Let's say this is only 3. Let's say option C is only 3, and therefore the correct answer will be what? Option C, only 3. Okay. And now let's move on to question number 2. This question guys can be asked in the one marker in the ESI section, and this is a very important question because it talks about India's first amputee clinic. India ka pehla amputee clinic established hua hai, and the question is in which institute it has been established. So this is very important question. Isme se zyada kuch bhi nahi padhna, and you can expect this question in your exam. Okay, aur exam mein jo question hoga wo bhi isi type ka aayega ki ye kahan pe establish hua hai India's first amputee clinic. So it has been guys established in option A, PGIMER Chandigarh. Chandigarh ka jo medical hospital hai PGIMER, usme this has been established, India's first amputee clinic. And we don't have to go in the detail of this amputee clinic, that is not required for the exam. Alright. And now let's move on to question number 3, which talks about the Niti Aayog's aspirational district ranking for the month of December 2020. So we are discussing this because हमारा RBI का exam आने वाला है, so the monthly ranking is also required. So December 2020 में नीति आयोग का aspirational district ranking में which district was number 1? Alright. Question is which district has topped the नीति आयोग's aspirational district ranking for the month of December 2020? And guys, talking about the aspirational district program, so it was launched in the year 2018. Remember the launch year also? It was launched in the year 2018 with an aim to transform the districts in the key social areas like education, health, telecommunication and other things. Jo infrastructure hai aur jo social sectors hai, usme improvement lane ke liye. This aspirational district program was launched in the year 2018 for key districts in our country. And if we talk about the ranking for the month of December 2020, so it's Shravasti district of Uttar Pradesh, which is at number 1. Then number 2 pe we have Dhalai in Tripura. Garhwa is at number 3 from Jharkhand, then Baksa from Assam, and then at number 5 it's Bokaro, and we all know Bokaro is in Jharkhand. Okay, so ye top 5 agar aapko yaad ho jate hain, then that is well and good, then but at least you have to remember the top 3 districts in this ranking, right? Which are Shravasti from Uttar Pradesh, Dhalai from Tripura, and Garhwa from Jharkhand. So therefore the correct answer should be what? Which district had top? So it's Shravasti from Uttar Pradesh. Option B will be the correct answer. And this question is also, guys, one marker. And this is also very, very important. Both the question number 2 and 3 are the very important question. This is India's first amputee clinic. Okay. And this talks about the Niti Aayog's aspirational district ranking. So this is equally important. And now let's come to question number 4, which is again a very important question, which is about the Democracy Index 2020. Which has been released by Economist Intelligence Unit, which is located in London. Okay, कहाँ पे है ये? London में है. Economist Intelligence Unit वो हर साल release करता है Democracy Index. So इस साल 2020 का launch किया है. So let's talk about this index. So as I told you, Economist Intelligence Unit, which is located in London, has released this Democracy Index 2020, and this index measures the state of democracies in various countries. And total this index has marked 167 countries. Total countries कितनी थी इसमें? 167. यहाँ पे लिखा हुआ है 167 countries थे, and there are 5 categories जिसके मदद से इस index को बनाया जाता है, and which are electoral process and pluralism, functioning of government, political participation, political cultures, and civil liberty. So you should remember the name of these 5 categories. This is important for the exam. But yes, you don't have to remember the name of all the indicators, which are 60 in number. Number of indicators कितने हैं? 60 हैं, तो उसका सबका नाम याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है, of course. But you should remember the 5 categories, okay? And also remember that there are 5 categories. कभी अगर भूल जाओ तो ऐसे याद रख लेना कि 5 categories थी, तो नाम याद आ जाएंगे. And according to this index, guys, there are 5 types of democracy in this world. Number 1 is full democracy. Then there are 23 countries which are classified as the full democracy according to this index for the year 2020. Flawed democracy. There are 52 countries and India has been classified under this category. India ki jo democracy hai, wo flawed democracy hai. Then hybrid regime, there are 35 countries. And finally, we have authoritarian regime. There are 57 countries in the world which are under authoritarian regime. And you can see here, authoritarian regime mein number of countries jo hai, wo sabse zyada hai, aur full democracy mein sabse kam. So you can see the status of democracy in the world. And now talking about the index. So once again, it is Norway which is at number 1. Norway number 1 pe hai. Then we have Iceland which is at rank 2. Sweden rank 3. And our pyara Bharat is at 53rd. While the last year, India's rank was 51. So 2 aur kam ho gaya hai. Aur jab tak desh mein aisi sarkare rahengi, aur kam hota jayega. India's score is how much? 6.61. So you should remember the score of India also. And now let's talk about the neighboring countries. Sri Lanka is 68. Bangladesh 78 and Afghanistan it's 139. So Afghanistan ka jo score hai, jo rank hai, that is obviously very poor. And India was ranked at 51st in the year 2019. Alright. So you should remember the top 3 countries, and you should remember the rank of India, of course, and the score of India. That is 6.61. And now let's come back to the question. So you have to identify the incorrect statements here. So remember, don't confuse between identifying the correct statement and the incorrect statement. As I told you earlier, there are 60 indicators in the index. This is absolutely correct. There are 60 indicators with 5 categories. 5 categories mein 60 indicators hain. Norway has been ranked number 1 in the index. This is absolutely correct. Norway number 1, Iceland number 2, Sweden number 3, India 53rd. And India's score was 6.61 with rank 53rd. This is absolutely correct, which means all the statements are correct. And we have to identify the incorrect statement. Therefore, option D. Option D, none is incorrect, should be the correct answer. And let's change this. This should be all are incorrect. Alright. This option should be all are incorrect. Option D, none is incorrect, will be the correct answer. Okay. And guys, that's it for the session. These are the 4 questions for the day. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.